sure they could continue the fight. They would form the Polish armed forces in the West, therefore emphasizing a continuity of Poland and a hope of liberation. In 1940, Polish forces landed in France. The Polish army in France numbered around 82,000 soldiers and officers. First deployed in Norway during the Battle of Narvik in April 1940, they would then play a role in the defense against German invasion in France in the same year. Unfortunately, many Polish units were ill-equipped by the poor French logistical system. Once France fell to the German invasion, General Władysław Sikorski was able to evacuate around 20,000 Polish troops to Great Britain, with the rest becoming prisoners of war. Forming in Scotland as the 1st Polish Corps under command of the British Army, they were first set the objective of defending the Fife region of eastern Scotland from possible German invasion. In 1941, another Polish army was formed and would be known as Anders Army. They were formed when Stalin agreed with the Polish government in exile to release Polish prisoners of war. This 75,000-strong army, which was part of the Polish armed forces in the east, as it was under Soviet control, made their way to the Middle East in 1942 to join the British command as the 2nd Polish Corps, becoming part of the Polish armed forces in the west. The 2nd Polish Corps would fight in Italy from 1943, and it was here that they would be victorious against veteran German units at the Battle of Monte Cassino. The Polish 1st and 2nd Corps, as a part of the Polish armed forces in the west, would go on to fight under British command in most of the Allied operations in the Mediterranean and Western Europe until the war's end. 210,000 soldiers fought in the Polish armed forces in the west, with approximately 26,800 killed or missing in action. Subscribe for more World War II videos.